Okay, today we are doing maintenance on a Shimano XT-RDM 8000 grid derailleur. Actually, this is my spare derailleur, but I just did this service on my regular one because it was squeaking like hell. So the tools you're gonna need for this are a 2 mm Allen key or hex key, a Phillips screwdriver, a 4 mm Allen key, preferable with a torque wrench, and I'm also using a large screwdriver, which you see later why. So, okay, let's start. I'm trying to stick to the Shimano manual here, which I'll link in the description. So the first step after removing it from your bike is to set the lever to the off position, like this. Actually, you can do this while it's installed on your bike, but it's just not as convenient. The second step is to remove the stopper pin, which is holding the cage in place. So take your Phillips screwdriver and screw it out. Oops, set it aside. Now rotate the cage. You first have to move the mechanism out of place so it can move. Ah, okay. Now we're going to remove the cover from the clutch mechanism. This will reveal the actual chain tensioner, which we now remove. Just remove it together. You should loosen the tension first. That was too heavy. Okay. I removed it. Set it aside for cleaning. Also remove the little rubber band so you don't lose it. And now we can remove the screw that holds the cage to the rest of the derailleur. Use the 4 mm Allen key for that. Note that the spring here will want to move the cage away. Remove the screw or plate axle, as Shimano calls it. Remove the spring. Going to be placed in the lower, in the lower hole. Remember that? At least for the XT, I don't know for any other. Your rollers, if they need service and cleaning or replacement, do whatever you want with it. Okay, basically we are finished now, and we can clean and re-grease the parts. This part here, or both these parts, actually were completely without grease and were squeaking like hell for me. I didn't even know there was a rubber band. Seeing this for the first time, maybe it's already dissolved. Okay. Interesting. Okay, cleaning part. The spring was pretty gnarly for me as well. It wasn't so easy to clean. The chain tensioner. We need to remove the inner part from the outer part, and this is where the large screwdriver comes in handy. Just gonna push this in. And now we can easily remove the inner part. Leave it here. Leave the screwdriver in, because you will need to reassemble it. Okay, re-greasing time. We are going to re-grease the plate axle and the inner part of the chain tensioner on the outside. I'm using PM600 here. Shimano says you should use their grease, but whatever. Important for the plate axle, only re-grease this part here. Do not grease this part. This part is where the axle connects to the chain tensioner. And if you grease this part, the chain tensioner might fail. Also for the same reason, do not re-grease, or do not grease at all the inner part here, only the outer part. Where there's grease, there can't be water. Put it back together. It should just slide in. Here we go. Yes. Found it easier to first insert the straight part of the spring. And then find the hole on the cage. Okay, now we have to give some resistance, and this is where you'll need a torque wrench. Shimano says you'll need 8 to 10 newton meters to tighten the screw. Now we have to twist the cage back into position and reinsert the locking pin. Maybe you want to add some thread lock on it. I don't. So move the derailleur out of the way. This way around. Hold the cage in place. Tighten the screw and the blocking pin prevents the cage from moving too far. Now we can reinsert the chain tensioner onto the derailleur. We need to make sure to align the square hole with the square pin, and also make sure that the race part, this one will press against the spring when the lever is moved into the on position. Also, the opening here has to be on the downside. The race part is pointing to the left when the lever is on off, and when you switch the lever to on, the race part is going down, pressing against the spring and activating the chain tensioner. It's a bit tricky, but it should slide in. Okay. Test the lever function. This is looking good. Screw in the tension screw a bit to test the lever. You should feel resistance. And yes, I do. Okay. Now reinstall the rubber band, which I like to grease. Move it in the right position. And what I also like to do is to add some extra grease with a bent paper clip. You can also use this to fit a rubber band into position. So, ready to install the housing again. And screws. Don't over tighten the screws. You might break something, and that's never good. Okay. Yep. The lever's functioning good. You can access the chain tensioning screw by opening this rubber plug. At least on the XT version. I have no idea about the SLX. Yes. Oh, that looks good. Okay. Now I'll just clean it up. And it's ready to be reinstalled on the bike. And that's it.